Alright. So this is question number 7 from your master in chemistry assignment. So, do you all have it?
Yeah.
So a student makes a stock solution of potassium hydroxide. Gets 10 grams of potassium hydroxide, adds water to it, and makes a solution, and the volume is 150 milliliters. And then the student does a couple of other dilutions and ends up with a 65 milliliter solution. We want to know what the molarity of the final solution is. So in order to get to that final solution, this student does a couple of dilutions before getting into the final solution. So first, the student gets 10 grams of potassium hydroxide, add water, and she ends up with a solution here, 150 milliliters of solution. And then from that solution, the student takes 15 milliliters, add water to it, and makes a solution that's 65 milliliters. Now, we want to know what the final molarity of this solution is. So since it's all potassium hydroxide from the beginning till the end, and all the student is doing is just doing dilution, adding more water to it, that tells you that you're going to do M1, V1 equals to M2, V2. And you see the word dilution in the problem. So as soon as you hear dilution, that tells you M1, V1 equals to M2, V2. That's what you need to use. And also keep in mind that in order to use M1, V1 equals to M2, V2, you have to be working with only one type of solution. It's potassium hydroxide from the beginning till the end. You can't have two different types of solution, two different types of compound when you do dilution. Alright? If you have two different things, that means you have to do a stoichiometry. You have to write a chemical equation. So, now, in order to find out the final molarity of the solution, we're going to figure out the solution, the molarity of this solution here first, and then you can plug it into M1, V1 equals to M2, V2, and easily find the molarity of the final solution. Now, let us start from the first solution, and we do step by step. We find the molarities of our solution step by step until we get to the end. So, at the beginning, this student gets 10 grams of potassium hydroxide, and makes a solution which is 150 milliliters. Now we gotta figure out what the molarity of this solution is. So in order to find the molarity, you know that molarity is moles of potassium hydroxide over liter of solution. So I'm solving for the molarity of the very first solution. So in order to find the molarity, you would need moles of potassium hydroxide and volume of solution. Volume of the solution is already given to you. It's 150 milliliters. But keep in mind that for molarity, this needs to be in liters. So that's the volume of the solution. And the number of moles of potassium hydroxide is easy, yes. So you just get 10 grams of potassium hydroxide. And you divide it by molar mass of potassium hydroxide. Where is my, does anybody see my calculator? Oh, it's there. Thank you. So, molar volume, molar mass of potassium hydroxide, 39.1. plus 16 plus 101, that's 56.11, is that correct?
Yes.
So from here, gram and gram cancel out, and you should end up with mole per liter. So 10 divided by 56.11 divided by 0.15, and how many stick figs do we want? 3? We want 3 significant figures. So that's 1.19 molar potassium hydroxide. So this is the molarity of this solution. So this is the molarity of the very first solution he made by just adding 10 grams of potassium hydroxide to a volumetric flask and adding water until the volume is 150 milliliters. Any questions so far? Is it clear how I found the molarity? Yes? Now we have a solution. What that means is that this solution here, I have 150 milliliters of 1.19 molar potassium hydroxide solution. Yes?
Why do we need three siblings for that?
Because this is 10. And this is three significant figures. This is four, and I'm just doing division. So I want three significant figures. So now, let's look at the second step. So now the student takes 15 milliliters of 1.19 molar potassium hydroxide. So this is a totally different problem now. So now, on the second step, this person gets 15 milliliters of 1.19 molar potassium hydroxide. And then he adds enough water to make a 65 milliliter solution. And we want to know what the molarity of this final solution is. So this is going to be your concentrated solution, and this is your dilute solution. So we just have to do another M1V1 equals to M2V2. So M1V1 equals to M2V2. So initially he starts with 1.19 molar potassium hydroxide. We have only 15 milliliters. We want to know the molarity if our volume is 65 milliliters. So from here, if you solve for molarity, which is going to be the molarity of your final solution, 1.19 times 15 divided by 65, that gives me 0.275 molar. So this is the molarity of your final solution.